In this video, you will learn the basics of StatCrunch, including how to load data, calculate basic summary statistics, construct simple graphs, interact with those graphs, and copy StatCrunch results into other applications. StatCrunch is a web-based statistical software package used for analyzing data that works on any desktop browser, such as Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, or Safari. StatCrunch also works with web browsers on smartphones or tablets running iOS, Android, and other mobile operating systems. After signing into StatCrunch.com, you are directed to your My StatCrunch page. You can also navigate to this page by clicking the My StatCrunch link at the top of every StatCrunch.com page. This page contains a listing of all the items you have created and saved on the StatCrunch.com site. My Data shows a listing of your saved datasets. My Results shows a listing of the results you have generated and saved using the software. There are also listings available for the reports, groups, and surveys you have created. Under My Data, there is an option for loading a file from your local computer into StatCrunch, and there are also links for loading a file from an internet location, directly entering data into an empty StatCrunch data table, or pasting data into the software. For this example, I am going to choose Select a File on my computer. The options for uploading a data file are shown over here on the left. StatCrunch can read text files and Microsoft Excel files. I'm going to click Choose File and locate the file I want to use on my computer. For this example, I'm going to use the College Worth It Excel file. This particular dataset contains information collected from a survey conducted at StatCrunch.com. Respondents to the survey were asked if college was worth the cost, with the possible answers being yes, no, or unsure. Respondents also provided their gender and age. The first line in this data file contains the column headings, so there is no need to turn off this option right here, Use First Line as Column Names option. Since this is an Excel file, there is no need to specify a delimiter, but this input is required for a text file. There are also options for sharing the dataset with others and for including additional information about the dataset. Notice you can even choose a thumbnail to represent your dataset. I'm going to go ahead and scroll down and click the Load File button, and the dataset will be uploaded to StatCrunch.com for analysis. The dataset is also being stored under My Data listing for future access. Now that we have our dataset loaded, let's perform some basic operations in StatCrunch. The Stat menu contains a number of procedures for summary statistics, tabulation, hypothesis testing, confidence intervals, regression, and much more. With this dataset, consider the task of computing the summary stats, such as mean and median ages of the respondents. To accomplish this task, under the Stats menu, I'm going to choose Summary Stats by Columns. I'm going to select the Age column and click Compute. This generates a table of summary statistics. The mean age of the respondents is shown to be roughly 29.31, and the median age of the respondents is much lower at a value of 23. To compute separate summary statistics for each value of gender, under the Options menu, choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we set up the table. Under the Group By box, I'll choose Gender. I'll click Compute. The mean age of female respondents and the mean age of male respondents are both very close to 29.3. The median ages of both genders are exactly 23. Now let's move on to the Graph menu. The Graph menu contains a number of options for displaying data in a variety of formats. To summarize how respondents felt about college being worth the cost, under the Graph menu, choose Bar Plot with Data. I'm going to choose the worth it column and click compute. In this case, the bar plot indicates that an overwhelming majority of respondents said that college was indeed worth the cost. Now, to break out these responses by gender, back under the options menu, choose edit. Again, in the group by box, let's choose gender and click compute. The split bar plot shown now shows the original responses color-coded by gender. Notice the female is in blue and the male is in red. Note the majority of those who answered yes were female. Most graphics in StatCrunch are interactive. This can be a very powerful feature. For example, to identify the number of females who said college was worth it, click and drag the mouse to form a rectangle which overlaps the bar. The selected data values are then highlighted in the graph and will also be highlighted in any other graphs that are produced. The rows corresponding to the selected values are highlighted in the data table as well. Clicking the down or up buttons in the lower left-hand corner of the window will scroll the data table to show the next or previous selected row. This is especially useful when a small number of rows have been selected in a large data table. Adjacent to these two arrow buttons, the value of 582 indicates how many rows have been selected. You can turn off highlighting at any time by clicking the clear button in the lower left-hand corner. Lastly, both tabular and graphical results can be saved to your My Results listing at StatCrunch.com, or they can be copied, printed, or downloaded. To copy the above bar plot on the screen, under the Options menu, I'm going to choose Copy. To finish copying the image, follow the tip provided for your platform as shown on the screen. After the image is copied, it can be pasted into other applications such as Microsoft Word or PowerPoint. I'm going to go ahead and close this. Saving, printing, and downloading are other options that can be found under the Options menu as well. Now, to move on to tabular results, that's even easier. To copy tabular results, click the results in the window and use standard keys on your platform to copy the selection. Then use standard paste keys to paste the results into an application such as Microsoft Word.